Hello everyone, my name is John Melisundra, and today I'm going to teach you on how to paint a portrait of a farmer. So I'm going to put the farmer in the rice field, and I think he will be or she will be planting rice on the rice field. Okay, and please don't forget to subscribe. You have to subscribe it and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications of my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see the five limited colors, the brushes that we need, and all the things that we're gonna need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now. I'm gonna do the underpainting first. So we have here the sketch. So we already have the sketch, everyone, and all you have to do is add the underpainting. Okay, so I'm very excited. So I'm gonna put the background first. I think I'm gonna use a bigger brush, 1.5 or 1 inch flat brush. You can use a little bit smaller, but not so small and not also so big, everyone. Okay, so yeah. So I can try this rhomber. There. I'm gonna try rhomber with a little bit of blue and the red. So we are going to add the underpainting first. Yeah, I'm gonna use blue, rhomber, and then red. So it should be dark background, everyone. I like to use dark, very dark background. And more rhomber and red. I want to show more the part of the farmer, everyone. So I'm gonna put also a little bit of greenish color here. Yellow. We can use a smaller brush later on there. So you can also add the color here. I have the rhomber. So I have also here the green. Little bit of light yellow, okay. Okay, you can also add a little bit of orange. As long as it will be dark, everyone, it will be fine. There. And then I'll try more blue under umber. And then some red also. Here. Okay, that's good. Put more umber. So I think this will be just an easy background, everyone. So now our background is thick and heavy. I'm gonna use now a bit of medium sized flat brush number eight. Okay, so this is a medium sized flat brush, number 8. I'm gonna use this one now. So again, I'm gonna mix for dark color with the red and the umber and the blue. And you can also use some umber. Yeah, you can just leave out our sketch, everyone. Okay, I want to make the background solid, everyone, so I will retouch everything here until it will become good or better. Okay, so if you are painting, let me just follow what I'm doing. There you go. I have some umber. There. So I just want to make the background dark, everyone, so that we can see our subject, which is the young old lady farmer. It will stand out onto our painting, so that will be good. If you're asking me if I have a reference photo, yes, I have, everyone. I got the reference photo from the from Pixabay. So if you want to find some reference photo, if you don't have a reference photo taken by yourself, you can download, you can search and find it in the Pixabay. You can have a lot of photo there. It's free to use. Just watch for the caption, free for royalty free photo, something like that. Or you can see there, free for commercial use. You can download it. Okay, so I am going now to slowly add the details on the background, everyone. So yeah, the background will not be so much detailed. I will just put some plants there, greenish plants, something like that, and then even some tree there, so it will be something like that. So I'll be using this bristle flat brush number 8. You can use any other bristle flat brush, everyone. Just medium size flat bristle flat brush, it will be fine. I have here the yellow and then blue, the blue and yellow, and then some amber. So just tapping technique, everyone. So here on the top. There. So add that, something like that, leaves, everyone. Look like grass, or yeah. There. And even here. You can also add a little bit of yellow on the red or orange. Then we can add more yellowish. Just a tapping technique, everyone. There, so yellow and the white, and then red and then yellow. So just stop and technique, everyone, and then you can create a beautiful background. Okay, so I will try to add some tree here, everyone. Yeah, maybe I'll try to add one tree here. I'm gonna use this raw umber with the white. I try to add a little bit dark here, some pure umber, so that it become dark here. You can add some umber, everyone, like that. There, and then we will use a smaller brush, a liner brush, like this. Same color, everyone, the light raw umber, just raw umber with the white. There, so we can add a lot of branch, everyone, as long as it will not, as long as you don't overdo it. There, okay, so we have something like that. Yeah, so far so good. It looks simple, but I'll try now to retouch. I'll try now to paint the person, everyone, the subject, which is the lady. Okay, the background of her is very contrast to the subject, so I like this one, everyone. Okay, so I'm going to start now painting the farmer. Okay. So yeah, start with the lahat. I'll be using a small brush, number 3. So we have here the raw umber with the white. And then I'm gonna try to use more white and a bit of yellow. And more white. So actually I'm leaving a white background, everyone. Actually it will make your painting brighter. Okay. Then I will try now to mix a little bit darker color. Clean your brush. So I have here the blue and the red to create some dark purple. Actually, you can use a smaller brush even if it's hard for you to use this brush. And then this one here. Yeah, and then this one also here. Okay, there you go. I'm gonna put more red and then umber. just slowly everyone build the tones. Okay, yeah, I will now build the tones of the flesh or the skin tone, everyone. So I'm gonna use this raw amber with the yellow, also red, more yellow. I think it will win, everyone. There, okay, so we have now a brown skin tone. And then also here. This is actually an Asian, everyone, that's why it's brown. Okay, now I'm going to put now some a little bit of orange on the shirt. So raw amber, yellow, and the red. A little bit of red. So it's a bit of brownish, everyone, but actually this will be orange, but since this part is dark, so we're going to use this orange brown, something like that. Just use the raw amber and then add some yellow and red. Okay, so I think it's gonna rain. I'm not sure if I can finish this one today. When you build the tones, everyone, just let it dry so that later on we can add another, because it takes time to dry this the color, okay, this acrylic. 30 minutes, or I think 5 minutes is enough. I have a red, and I'm gonna also try to blend it here. There. Just put red, more red on the raw umber, everyone, and it will be good. Just red on the raw umber. Okay, and then I'll try to add red and then a little bit of white. I think it's gonna rain. Yeah, it's gonna rain, everyone. I have to stop for a bit because it's raining now. Hello, everyone. So the rain will stop. And I'm gonna continue on this part here. So yeah, I'm gonna paint here some orange. Yeah, it takes I think more than 30 minutes. Everyone, after 30 minutes, the rain stopped, and I can continue now. So I have here the yellow and the red. Always remember, everyone, just to fill everything first. Take erase or cover all the whites there. Very, very important. In my case, I don't want to see those white things there. Yeah, maybe I will try to cover also this one. And even this. Okay, there you go. Now let's slowly retouch everything. I'm gonna use now a small brush. This brush, everyone, 000 liner brush. You can also use 1 liner brush or 0 or 00. I'm gonna use now this umber, and then I have here the red and then yellow. And then I'm gonna use some white. Yeah, it's a flesh color, everyone. There.
Metamix for a bit darker. So I have here the red, the umber, and the yellow. Okay. I'm gonna put a little bit of orange here. It's a bit of reflection coming from the dress or from the shirt. There. Okay. And I'll try now more on the umber, everyone. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so slowly everyone, I will build the tones, the shadows, the lights. Yeah, slowly it's becoming realistic. So we have here the umber. I'll try to darken some parts. There you go. So I think it looks good now, and it even look realistic. There, I like that. You can add a bit of white. Okay, and then I'll start adding the details on the hat. A bit of details on the hat, everyone. So I'm using the umber, the pure umber. Okay, and I'll try the dark color, red and the blue.
hair.
And then I'll try some umber, a little bit of white. So I'm gonna try to retouch hair one.
Okay,
gonna add some white. I'm gonna put on the other side here a little bit lighter. Lighter or umber.
There.
Then I'm gonna use some white. So we just make it brighter, everyone, this part here. It's like a good light striking on this part. Okay, that's good. I'm gonna put a little bit of details here. So I'll just use this lighter purple, or this purple here, everyone. Then I will try to use a little bit darker to blend some parts. There, okay. That's it. So you can see now. Bit of details there. Yeah, we'll try to retouch everyone. I think Let's try to retouch some parts. There. Yeah, just she's a bit looking like she's laughing, okay? And now let's I'm gonna try to move now this part here. So I'll just be using a bigger brush, everyone. This medium size flat brush. I know a small flat brush number 3. So I have here the yellow and the red, and then white. It's just yellow and white, everyone. You can use that. A bit of red. I'm gonna put a little bit of yellow, yellowish tones, everyone, like that, so that we can see that this part looks so bright. Okay, there you go. So I'll try to use now. Yellow and the white. There. I just want that part to look glowing, everyone. It should look glowing. It's like it's glowing. There, yeah, and now we are going to put some orange or red and then yellow. There we go. And then another orange here. Yeah, it's 1 AM. That's why chickens are lazy. Okay. And now let's start to add a bit of dark there. I'll be using now a bigger brush, a flat brush here. Number 10 on a flat brush. So yeah, I'm gonna try to use a bit darker one. I have here the umber with the yellow and the red. So I like it here, when it looks realistic now, and also here. Also here. I have also to darken that part, everyone. Let's go. The color is a little bit reddish, reddish brown. Okay. So it's a lighter reddish brown, everyone. Just add white, red, amber, and white to create this color. Okay, I have here the amber and the red. More red here. So slowly we can going to blend a little bit. There you go. Yeah, so you can see now those details there, and then I'm gonna try to use some red and the yellow, so this time it will be a bit lighter. Yeah, a little bit reddish.
Okay. And then here. Okay, so here. Yeah, so you can see now everyone, this part is has warm color, and this one here a little bit of cold. So yeah, it's blending now. So I love it. I will use a bit darker color, so blue and the red. There. I think this tutorial is gonna be long, everyone, but I think it will be worth to watch. Okay, and also here, everyone, I'm gonna put some darks. Yeah, I just have to blend it good, and when you watch it on the far, it will be looking great. Yeah, it doesn't have to be perfect, everyone. Even in my reference, it's not so very close, but yeah, it for me it looks good, and I am good with that. Okay, so here. So these are some lots of three, everyone, or something like that. Okay, so I will retouch now this part here. So this punch, everyone, will be a little bit red. Yellow and in white.
Yeah. I'm gonna put some white here. There, okay. There you go. And then I will try now to add some details, everyone. So I have the raw umber and then red. So it has a slice here. Red and then blue. There. Okay. Yeah, this part of one I'm gonna make it dark. So we have here the blue and the red. So all I have to do is blend and blend and blend. Layers by layers, everyone, is very, very important. You have to blend until you get the desired colors or blending you want. Okay, now I'm gonna try to add a little bit of white there. So I'm gonna put it on the back also to add a bit of light here. There, blue and the red. There you go. So yeah, I like it, everyone. It looks good. Yeah, I'm just trying to retouch more here. I'm gonna put white here. So I have here the raw umber. I'm gonna put
yellow and the red, and then a lot of white. These are some, I don't know, maybe some weeds, everyone. There. Yeah, pretty romber. Yeah, so simple. And then here also, I think this one will be green, everyone. So I'm gonna use now some yellow and the blue. There. I have the blue and the yellow and the red. So just darken everyone, put it here and about in the base part. Yeah.
And I have here the yellow and then white. It's a plant, everyone, so she's gonna plant that. Then I'm gonna use a smaller flat brush. I have here the blue and the red, with the dark amber, dark purple. There you go. Yeah. Yeah, just a simple portrait, everyone. And then I'm gonna try to paint now the hand. So again, the umber, the red, and the yellow. For the flesh color, then white. Okay. And then not so white. Okay. And then I'm gonna mix light brown around, so yeah, I'm gonna use this one. here, and then I'm gonna put some white. These are some like bushes, everyone, or some dried plants. So I'm gonna lighten the background, everyone, especially the grass is there. I want to make it good, okay? So here. So I have a bristle flat brush. Yeah. So I have a little bit of yellow and the red. And then the umber. I can put a brownish grasses here. Greenish also. So these are grasses, everyone. I'm using the bristle flat brush. Here some light brown. And then I have here the yellow. I'm gonna put some blue. These grasses, everyone, are rice field, okay? These are rice, because she's in the middle of the rice field. She's planting some, I don't know if she's planting or, I don't know. But I think, yeah, she's just planting or she's taking some.
So just drag it down like that, everyone. Yeah. It's not so hard to create the grasses details. Just do like that. And make sure that your brush is dry. It should be something like a dry brush technique. Yeah, something like that. There. And then we can put now, start adding now some grasses there, okay? So I'm gonna add some white here and then yellow. Yeah, just do like that, everyone. Those are cats, everyone. Sorry about the cats, everyone. So here, we just have to do like that. Sorry about the cats, everyone. That doesn't bother you. Yeah. So just do it slowly, everyone, like that.
Okay. Yeah, I think I am almost done, everyone. There, so you can see now, it looks like there's a lot of grass there, a lot of grasses. Yeah, it makes it look realistic and beautiful. So yeah. So I'm almost done, everyone. So I will just try to retouch more on the bottom part. Especially here, I want this to be brighter. And I will be finished. So just use the zero liner brush, or if you have smaller than that, these are triple zero brush. These are lighter, everyone. There. Can also put longer. Okay, everyone. So, yeah, I think something else that I'm gonna need to add on the painting, everyone. So, I think I'm gonna put something like plants here. So I will be using this flat brush. Try up here. The flat brush with the blue color. And yellow. Add a little bit of water. There, okay. Just plants with the bigger leaves, everyone. Just grass with the bigger leaves. Okay, just to balance everything there. And maybe even here, I can also put. I don't know, maybe here. Also here. I just want to make everything balance, everyone. There. Sorry about that. I think someone is doing something there on the outside. And then I'm gonna try to add some white. Make on the top a little bit shiny. A little bit bluish. There. Yeah, and then I'll try to put some flowers, maybe some red flowers, something like that. And then some white. And then I'll try a bit darker greens, blue and the yellow. I have no yellow. I'll put a bit of red. Yeah, just add a little bit of dark also. There, okay. So that's it, everyone. I think I am done and everything looks good. I like the additional things there. It makes it looks better and the entire view looks complete, okay?
Okay, everyone. So I want to say thank you for watching this video today and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.